الصيام وأقل مصعدا أهلا وخلا لته في كل حين.
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Thank you for joining us for another edition in our series Serenity in Salah. We begun this series by speaking about the fact that in order to attain serenity in Salah, we need two basic concepts. One of them is to understand and know the things that we are doing in prayer, what they mean, what they represent. And also, on the other hand, is to connect our heart with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so we begun by this fact of trying to connect our hearts to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and trying to revive the emotions necessary so that when we're standing in prayer, we feel as though we are connected to our Lord and to our Creator. So first we started to speak about the emotion of hope, to have a hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then we spoke about having a fear and reverence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today we want to speak about a different emotion that your heart necessarily needs to feel when you stand in front of Allah. And it is more important than the other two that we mentioned. With this feeling, it will allow your prayer, the 4-minute prayer that you pray, without it, it would feel like it's an hour long. But with it, it would feel like it's just too short and you need to pray more and you need to stand in prayer more. You know, you'd be standing for 10 minutes and you'll finish your prayer and be like, wow, I was actually standing for 10 minutes. You wouldn't even feel the time. Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, he speaks about this beautiful emotion. He says, فَهُوَ الَّذِي يَتَنَافَسَ فِيهِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ وَإِلَيْهِ شَمَرَ السَّابِقُونَ وَهُوَ غِدَاءُ الْأَرْوَاحِ وَقُرَّةِ الْعُيُونِ. He said that it is what the strivers strive for, what the people who are striving to get to Jannah, what it is that they are striving for. It is what the previous generation was ready for, the companions and the righteous people. He said it is the meal of our souls, it's what the souls are sustained with, and it is the coolness of our eyes. And then Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala continued, and he said, مَتَا خَلَى الْقَلْبُ مِنْهُ فَهُوَ كَالْجَسِدْ الَّذِي لَا رُوحَ فِيهَا فهو النور وهو الشفاء وهو اللذة الذي لم يظفر بها فليس له عيشة فمن لم يظفر بها فعيشته كله هموم وألم. He said that whenever the heart becomes bare, whenever the heart becomes empty of this emotion, then it is like a body that has no soul. It is like a body that has no soul. And then he said, indeed it is the light, and indeed it is the cure, and indeed whoever does not benefit from this emotion, then their life is full of anxiety and full of pain. Did you understand? Did you know what emotion we are speaking about today? It's the emotion of love. Having love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now some people, many of us, and you know, myself included, sometimes we see the religion as having nothing to do with love. We see the religion as nothing but a series of commandments. That we were ordered to pray, so let's get up and pray. That we were ordered to fast, so let's fast. That we were ordered to give charity, so let's give some zakat. But we don't have any connection to the deen other than that. We don't feel like the religion is giving us anything more than that. That simply our relationship with Allah is simply us trying to avoid the hellfire due to fear and us trying to get to Jannah with hope. But there's nothing more than that. But in reality, why do we worship Allah anyways? I mean, what's the point of worship? What's the reason behind worship? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَنْ يَرْتَدِدْ مِنْكُمْ عَنْ دِينِ فَسَوْفَ يَأْتِ اللَّهُ بِقَوْمٍ يُحِبُّهُمْ وَيُحِبُّونَ. He said that all you who believe, whoever turns away from this religion, turns their back on this religion, then indeed Allah will bring about a people whom He loves and they love Him. SubhanAllah. It's as though Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, you know, the purpose for worship is not that you never sin, not that you never make mistakes, is that you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah doesn't want you to be on automatic mode. Allah does not want you to pray like a machine that has no connection with Allah, but He wants you to love Him. So He says, if you turn your back, He will bring forth a people, not a people who pray, not a people who fast, but a people who love, that Allah loves and that they love Him. And so this is the very point of our worship. And if we don't worship Allah with this emotion, if our worship is disconnected from the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will get rid of us and bring forth the people who do worship Him with love. And so yesterday, you know, we were speaking about how Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala was speaking about how the worshipper is like the bird. He gave the analogy of a bird, that one wing of the bird is hope and the other wing of the bird is fear. And what I actually didn't tell you in the last lecture that we had is what Ibn Qayyim actually said. He said that, the worship is like a bird, and that one wing is hope and the other wing is fear. He said, but the brain of the bird, the mind of the bird, is the love of Allah. So yesterday we were saying, if you clipped off one of the wings, you know, the bird couldn't really do much. It would walk around, it might not find enough food, and it might die after a little while. But if the bird didn't have a brain, didn't have a mind, then, you know, there would not be any bird anyways. It would not exist at all. It would not be alive. And those who try to worship Allah with no love of Allah in their hearts, honestly, their worship is not alive. And it's just like Ibn Qayyim said, it's like a body with no soul. And so, you know, the purpose of this entire series that we are doing, the sole purpose of this series, is so that you can feel delight, and you can feel pleasure, and you can feel happiness when you stand between the hands of Allah in prayer. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said a beautiful hadith. He said, ثلاثة من كنا فيه وجد بهن حلاوة الإيمان. He said that there are three things. There are three things, and whoever discovers any one of them will discover the sweetness of faith, the sweetness of iman. And the first one that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned was أن يكون الله ورسوله أحب إليه مما سواهما. That Allah and His Messenger are more beloved to them than anything else. Than anything else. Than, you know, your wife or your kids or your children, you know, your children or your money or your job or your cars or your clothes or anything. Your status amongst the people, Allah is more beloved to you than anything else. When you reach that level, you will have truly tasted the sweetness of faith. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَتَّخِذْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ أَنْدَادًا يُحِبُّونَهُمْ كَحُبِّ اللَّهِ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبًّا لِلَّهِ. Allah said that indeed there are some people who take other than Allah as equals. And they love them as they should love Allah. But those who believe, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبًّا لِلَّهِ. But those who believe, their most intense love is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, sometimes, you know, there are people, you know, when a husband, you know, sees his wife, or when a wife sees her husband after a while, and they meet each other. For example, if you go and you meet your father or your mother, and they were overseas for a while, and you go to the airport and you're waiting for them to come back, and you're standing there, you know, hoping for them, and as soon as you see them, you know, what is that emotion that you have? Your heart begins to flutter and your heart begins to shake, and you start feeling, you know, these beautiful emotions, because you're meeting the person who you love. But many of us, when we stand in prayer and we stand between the hands of Allah, you know, we don't feel that same emotion. We should feel that, because we're meeting the one that we love. And we're standing in front of the one that we love. And so our heart should flutter, and our heart should shake, and our heart should feel like that when we stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبٍّ لِلَّهِ. But those who believe, their most intense love is for Allah. Their most intense love is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so now you might ask the question, how can we cause ourselves? How can we make ourselves love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How can we make sure that we love Allah azza wa jal? The most important thing when we try to answer this question is, you know, look at the verse that we mentioned previously, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that if you turn your back on this religion, فَسَوْفَ يَأْتِ اللَّهُ بِقَوْمٍ يُحِبُّهُمْ وَيُحِبُّونَ. That Allah will bring forth a people, meaning will get rid of us and bring forth another people, who He loves and they love Him. Now listen to how Allah says that. He loves and they love Him. So Allah mentioned His love for the slaves before He mentioned the slaves' love for Allah. And it's as though Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is indicating in this verse that in order for us to love Him, that it is impossible for us to love Allah until we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves us. And this is because humans naturally, you know, are very selfish beings. We're very selfish naturally. And so it is very difficult, it's almost impossible for us to love anything unless we know that they love us back. Unless we know that, you know, that they're good for us and that they're benefiting us. And so you need to know that Allah loves you so that you can have that love of Allah in your heart. Look at how much Allah Azza wa Jalla loves you, and feel that emotion in your heart when you stand in front of Allah in prayer, so that you too, inshallah, can feel serenity in prayer. Join us, inshallah, tomorrow. We're going to continue with the same subject, because I don't feel like we got, you know, we got a great amount of depth into this subject. So join us tomorrow. We're going to talk more about the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the things that should show you, the signs that should show you how much Allah loves you as His slave and as His creation. Jazakum Allahu khayrun. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.